Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. In the continuation of safety series, in this session we will learn some basic idea about fire detection and protection system. We will see all the major techniques which are used in fire protection. So let's begin with the introductory part of the topic. We will see the definition of fire. It is a chemical process of decomposition in which rapid oxidation of a fuel produces heat and light. There are three basic elements which must be present for a fire to occur. First one is fuel, second one is heat, and the last third one is oxygen. These all elements must be at appropriate proportion. Now we will see the most common thing regarding fire safety, which is fire triangle. This shows all the three elements in factorial form to understand better. If we look into the basic fire safety principle, then we will see that preventing the combination of the three elements will prevent a fire. If one of the elements is removed from the fire situation, the fire will be extinguished. Now we will see the types of fire protection system: hydrant system, water spray system, fixed foam system, gas-based fire extinguishing system, fire detection and alarm system, portable fire extinguishers. We will discuss each of them one by one. Now we will see the various important applicable codes which are used in fire detection and protection system. There are various applicable codes regarding the fire detection and protection system. These codes you can read from Google for better understanding. Here we will skip this part. Now we are entering into the core topic. Fire water pump house is the heart of fire protection system because it pumps the water to the pipe network so as to extinguish fire. Here we have taken a drawing of fire water pump house for better clarity about the topic. From the diagram you can clearly see that there are two tanks. Apart from that, there are two main pump, two diesel pump and two jockey pump which is connected to the suction header. Also there is a common recirculation line which is again connected to the top of water storage tank. There is common discharge header which is further distributed to the spray headers, hydrant lines, etc. Also there are various panels like MCC panel, engine control panel, control cum enunciation panel, etc. to control the operation of pumps. In normal condition, the pressure in fire water network will be capped at 11 kg per centimeter square. In case of any minor leakage in the system, the pressure in the fire water network will gradually drop down, which will be sensed via a pressure switch and will operate the selected jockey pump automatically. Once the system pressure is maintained, the jockey pump will stop automatically. When the hydrants or deluge valves are operated, in case of a fire, the pressure in the fire water network will drastically drop down, thereby operating the fire pump sequentially. Here it should be noted that the jockey pumps and the fire pumps are interlocked, such that the jockey pump will stop as soon as the fire pump is started. Here from the list of pressure setting, the system is maintained at 11 kg per centimeter square. When there is pressure drop, which is 10.5 kg per centimeter square, first jockey pump will start. When there is continuous decrease in pressure at 10 kg per centimeter square, second jockey pump will start. Similarly at 9.5, first main fire pump will start, then at 9, second main pump, at 8.5, third main pump, at 8, fourth main pump, at 7.5, first diesel engine will start, and at last, at 7 kg per centimeter square pressure, second diesel engine will start. Now moving to the next module, which is hydrant system. Here we will see its major components, working principle, etc. The main components of hydrant system are pumping system, hydrant valves, water monitors, hose pipes, hose box, branch pipes, pipe network, valves, etc. Hydrant system is the backbone of firefighting system. It is provided throughout the entire plant area, including the upper floors of multi-story buildings. It is manually operated system also. Some important hydrant system equipments are shown in the figure, which we have already discussed earlier. Now we will discuss about water spray system. There are mainly two categories of water spray system: medium velocity water spray system, high velocity water spray system. Generally, medium velocity water spray system is used in storage tanks, LDO, HFO tanks, coal conveyors, etc. On the other hand, high velocity water spray system is used in transformers. In this module, we will see the detailing of water spray system, its components, working, etc. The major components of high velocity and medium velocity water spray systems are pumping system, deluge valves, water motor gong, spray nozzles, QB detectors, a spray pipe network, detection pipe network, various instruments like solenoid valve, pressure gauge, pressure switch, etc. High velocity water spray system is a fixed pipe system connected to the pumping system and equipped with spray nozzles for a specific water discharge and impingement over the surface to be protected. It creates very fine water droplets and employs three principles of fire extinguishment: emulsification, cooling, and smothering. The fine water particles and the steam generated from the hot surface envelop the equipment, thereby cutting off the oxygen supply. Along with the spray network, a separate network of 25 NB detection network is provided, in which QB detectors are provided at a strategic location for detection of fire. The detection piping is connected to the upper chamber of deluge valve. Here we will see the major components of deluge valve and its working principle. The major components of a deluge valve assembly are bypass gate valve, main isolation gate valve, solenoid valve, trim kit assembly, water motor gong, drip drain, pressure switch in detection pipe, pressure switch at DV outlet, deluge valve local control panel, etc. Here we will see the technical specifications of high velocity spray nozzles and quartz valve detectors. Here K factor and angle plays a vital role in covering the fire extinguishing area. The QB detector senses the threshold temperature limit and bursts down, which leads to a spray of water. Medium velocity water spray system creates medium sized water droplets, which is employed for controlling the burning and to provide cooling or protection to the risk. The medium sized droplets can successfully control the burning and bring down the flame height. Here, the nozzles of medium velocity water spray system differs from the nozzle of high velocity water spray system. I would like to discuss one more thing, which is FM and UL listing. Basically, these both are international standards, which focuses on the quality and safety aspects. Now, we will see the water curtain system, which is provided for ammonia storage area. This system provides a flat curtain of water around the ammonia storage tanks, thereby segregating the storage tanks and preventing the spread of ammonia gas to the adjacent areas. In the event of a leakage of gas or fire, the system shall be operated manually by operating the quick operating valve. The nozzle of this water curtain system differs from high velocity water spray system and medium velocity water spray system, as the application of the system is very different from others. In this module, we will see the fixed foam system, its elements and its working principle. Foam system is used for extinguishing fires involving flammable liquids. Foam is lower in density than flammable liquids. Foam is a blanketing and cooling agent that is produced by mixing into a foam solution that contains water and foam concentrate. It flows freely over a burning liquid surface and forms a tough air excluding continuous blanket that seals volatile vapors from access to air. The system employs bladder tank proportional system for induction of foam concentrate. Now, moving to the next module, which is addressable fire detection and alarm system. Addressable fire detection and alarm system provides early warning and exact location of fires by detecting them at the early stage, so that effective countermeasures like evacuations of persons or automatic activation of fire extinguishing system can be achieved. Fire alarm system can be used for tripping off heating, ventilation and air conditioning systems and actuating fire dampers to prevent spreading of fire to unaffected areas. The system consists of following components: fire alarm panel, multi-sensor photoelectric type smoke detectors. Now, we will discuss the advanced technique, inert gas, inertgen based fire suppression system, which is used in fire extinguishment. Inert gas system is an environmental friendly fire extinguishing gas blend from natural existing atmospheric gases, nitrogen, argon and CO2 in the proportion of 52%, 40% and 8% respectively. Here, from the drawing of inert gas system, you can clearly see that left side cylinder's bank is main cylinder bank and right side cylinder bank is standby cylinder bank. Here, both cylinder bank consist of master cylinder and slave cylinder. At first, master cylinder is operated, then slave cylinders are operated.
An Inergen Clean Agent fire suppression system is both innovative and flexible in design. Inergen is a combination of three naturally occurring inert gases from the Earth's atmosphere. It is comprised of 52% nitrogen, 40% argon and 8% carbon dioxide, common components of the air we breathe. Inogen is stored in a series of steel cylinders located outside of the protected areas. When smoke, heat, or particulates are detected, an electronic signal is sent to the autopulse control unit, triggering a series of critical actions. Audio and visual alarms are started. The ventilation systems are closed off. After the prescribed time-delayed period, the autopulse control unit energizes the electric actuator on the Inogen cylinder valve. The cylinder valve opens, allowing the Inogen agent to discharge from the storage cylinders. In places where Inogen is protecting more than one room, a unique selector valve is used to direct the system discharge into the appropriate zone. A check valve is used in a selector valve system to separate the discharge of one zone from the other zone by preventing the Inogen flow to the main system cylinders. Simultaneously, one or more pressure switches can be actuated to pneumatically operate electrical circuits to close doors, trigger alarms, and turn on or off equipment. The Inogen agent is then distributed throughout the piping network. In overhead installations, nozzles are fitted with a deflector shield to direct the agent flow into the hazard. These specifically designed nozzles quickly discharge Inogen into the protected zone. As the Inogen clean agent completely floods the protected area, the oxygen content in the air is diluted below 15%, suppressing the fire hazard. This oxygen level is safe for people in occupied spaces, while it will not support combustion. Safe, effective, and environmentally harmless, Inogen is the clean agent that works.
If we talk about the capacity of each cylinder, the storage capacity is 140 liter and pressure is 300 bar, which is very high. Now, this is our last module, which is portable fire extinguishers. Broadly, portable fire extinguishers are divided into 6 categories based on application. For example, A for freely burning materials such as wood, paper, etc. B for flammable liquid such as petrols, spirit. C for flammable gases such as propane and butane. D for burning metals. E for electrical fires. F for cooking oil and fat. Based on the application, different type of extinguishers can be used as represented in the matrix shown in the screen. I hope you have liked the session. Stay tuned for more informative videos related to safety. Thank you.